So good morning, dear participants. Today's topic is usefulness of Raster and Grammarly as research tools. Today's speaker, our librarian, Dr. Nimai Shah, Vishwabharati University. Dr. Nimai Shah is a scholar, educationist, and very good library professional, as well as resource person. He wrote many articles, books in national and international journal also. So may I request to Dr. Nimai Shah, please start your topic. Thank you.
Invisible screen. Okay, so mute. Yeah. So very good morning, and this is supposed to be the last and final very good morning, because today is the last session of our second National VVLN webinar 2020, where we have actually 10 series of sessions or lectures, and today I am lucky to be the last man of this session, which has been started by our Honorable Upacharya Professor Bidyut Chakraborty with his valuable presentation under the topic Comprehending Research Methodology. And in mid there are 8 more lectures, and today I am the 10th presenter under the title Research Tools, Raster and Grammarly. And basically, since today is the last in its nature of second VVLN National Webinar 2020, let me allow, as we are already 10 minutes late, and at the end of my lecture, definitely I will take some valuable remarks from the learned participants, which will be recorded as our encouragement, as our learning, as our feedback for next course of our journey. Because from the first session we have learned a lot how to organize a kind of webinar accordingly. The suggestion given by the learned participants, we have already tried to address the issues. And you have already experienced that all days little problems were there to conduct the webinar session. Out of that, if I am not note today's session, first one is Dr. Kaushik Ghosh. That day, soon after the starting of 5-6 minutes, we have been a paused of 20 minutes due to technological disturbance. Again, when Dr. Sanath Bhattacharya was going to start his lecture, it was so apologized from my side that day we were 40 minutes late. And I'm really grateful to all the learned participants for their holding patience and kind cooperation, showing that day 40 minutes late is too much to start the session. And also I am very thankful to my speaker of that particular day, Dr. Sanath Bhattacharya, who is having a kind of patience. In one side, he was the co-host of the session, and at the same time, he was the speaker of that day. So let us see, actually, like a coin, we have two sides of the technology, odds and events. So as far as my educational philosophy, my attitude, my perception is concerned, I don't like to consider, and I don't try to take so much of care on negativity. I am always try to love to go by positive and try to go by our positive attitude, not only to me, but my entire teamwork. And for this session, for this second webinar session, the two persons who have been soldiering this kind of 10 days and before 10 days they have started, and after 10 days still certification giving and then kind of collection of feedback, they will act. That is none other than Dr. Tapas Kumar Das, one of the deputy librarian of Vishwa Bharati, and Dr. Sanat Bhattacharya, one of the assistant librarian of Vishwa Bharati. So they are taking the responsibility to carry out these things. And before starting to my topic, let me extend my heartfelt gratitude to all of them and to both of them, and definitely to participants, those who may not attend today and those who have attended today, and those who may not attend today due to technological threats. So including all, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude, my sincere thanks to one and all before to take entry on my topic. So now let me go by slide. See, let me just open up my today's menus of presentation. Basically, the same has been categorized in 5 points: introduction, register, then Grammarly, and then online demonstration under question, and then conclusion. Why under question? See, actually, online demonstration, I am always fumbling. As far as my recent experience on technology is concerned, I don't know whether my technology will allow me to go ahead for an online demonstration in one way, and on another way, whether I will have much time to go around that. And that's why I'm just preparing my slide as far as practicable, as far as elaboration on the coding. On the basis of that snapshot, let me go out. See, let me go at first introduction. And since I am from land of Tagore's, and I'm lucky at present to heading the Vishwa Bharati Library Network as in charge, and the institute was set up by Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore, who's supposed to be the first Nobel laureate in Asia, who's supposed to be the founder of this Vishwa Bharati. And for that particular reasons, we all are here to pass our days, to nurture our families. Thousands of thousands, lakhs of lakhs students are taking learning from here. And this is the morning when I'm just going to utter his one of the pertinent and greatest and important quotation on education, what he actually told 100 years back, which is equally and rightly and perfectly applicable in this current technological scenario, more specifically in this pandemic too. The highest education is that which does not merely give us information, but makes our life in harmony with all existence. And here you see, with all existence means goods and bads, odds and events, pandemics and fortunate times. So he very efficiently uttered the word, the highest education is that which does not merely give us information, but makes our life in harmony with all existence. And yes, that is why during this pandemic, institution is closed, library is closed, but not librarian. And that is why by sitting in the Vishwa Bharati Library, we are every day and night providing, feeding nascent information for our academics and students and scholars for their safe journey, uninterrupted journey on their academic work. Yes, this may not be able to 100% satisfy to all of them. Still, it is better than 100% lock, a little percentage, or to some percentage it is unlocked. So before starting, we have to take care of this proverb that library is locked down but not the librarian. And that is why this Vishwa Bharati Library Network is today is going to deliver 21st lecture Because first webinar session, we have 11 lectures, and in the second webinar session, we are having another 10. So in total, we are having 21st session. So from this, it is easily and simply, you all are ready to capture that how Vishwavarti Library Network people, how Vishwavarti Library Network, here librarian means, I don't want to mean myself, because it is a library professional, all the team members of our Vishwavarti Library Network, who are working day and night, and always who are one phone call ahead, one WhatsApp communication ahead to cater the service to our academics. Now let me come to the agenda. See, actually, we all are living in the society of research, and our basic target is to escalate the quality of research and enhance the periphery of research, so that the scholars of today's or the present society and the learned guides of the research, they will safe proceed. And that is why it's a great quotation from Werner von Braun, that research is what I am doing when I don't know what I am doing. So beyond this, research cannot be defined. Any more sentence, any more conception is required so far, I think. You see, it's a great signaling message before all of us, which is truly applicable, that research is what I am doing when I don't know what I am doing. So that is what it is, research. Now, you see, why is research important? You all are knowing, I'm not going to line by line read up, but two, three points I need to point out, that a tool for building knowledge and for facilitating learning, means to understand various issues and increase public awareness, and aid to business success. Here business does not mean commercial business. Here business means all other business, including academic, research and development activities, defense activities, all these things coming together under the term umbrella called success. That is, business success means where we are just going to make ourselves busy. That is called business, a way to prove lies and to support truths. The basic importance of research is a way to prove lies and to establish truths. That means to find, gauge, and seize opportunities. A seat to love reading, writing, analyzing, and sharing valuable information. And finally, a nourishment and exercise for the mind. You see, this today's society, when we are guided by mobile, then this online laptop, computer, internet, game, video, cinema, audio, everything, means our human body factory, that is called nervous system, it don't have anything exercise or acculturation of its nervous system. And that's why by these research activities, by reading, by writing, by social sharing, by corresponding, by interacting with each other, we are just going to nurture our mind for our better health, for our tomorrow's life, for the betterment of the citizen too. And that is why during this COVID-19 pandemic, this kind of webinar, this kind of interaction, this kind of, some sort of interaction is much more important in one way for the betterment of our health consciousness, so that we will just avoid to some extent from that pandemic. Otherwise, if we think about the Corona-19, every day in India is going to arrested by 17,000-18,000 people. So if I think, I don't know, after 1 hour, I may be arrested. After 2 days, what will be my life? After 3 days, what will be future of my family life? After 7 days, what will be my neighboring life? And then Bolpur, and then West Bengal, and then India, and finally globe. So this is a kind of alternatives through which we can just avoid and exercise our brain mind for our safe journey. And now let me come, what about tools of research? Many people just mixing it out in the academic corridor. Perhaps the tools of research or research tools and research methodology are same. My dear learned colleagues, it's completely different from each one to other. Research methodology and research tools is not the same. I have one slide through which I will just exemplify you, but now let me tell that what is research tools. Research tools is basically, you see, a specific mechanism or strategy the researcher uses to collect, manipulate, or interpret data. This is very, very narrower implications or importance of research tools, because earlier days, just you say 5 years back, by research tools, we want to mean the means of collecting of data on a particular survey research. That is questionnaire method, survey method, observation method, schedule method, interview method. So these all are called research tools. Questionnaire is a research tools like that. But today, what I am just going to explore, research tool is something else, something broaden of that data collection tools. So the library and its resources must be the tools of the researchers or research. The computer and its software, very, very carefully, just remark it. The computer and its software, then techniques of measurement, then statistics, the human mind, and the facility with language. Then you see, tools of research, why we require tools of research? Tools are chosen to facilitate research tasks simply and easily. Some researchers need special tools indigenous to particular discipline. The concern here is with the general tools of research, the majority of the researchers, regardless of discipline and the situation, typically need to derive meaningful and insightful conclusions from the data they collect. Be careful not to equate tools of research with the methodology of research. You see what I am just going to earlier slide. You see that things equally here, the tools of research with may not be equate with the methodology of research. Then finally, phrases such as library research, statistical research suggest basic confusion. For this particular arena, we need to use research tools. And finally, by using a research tools, we need to comply, we need to complete our research journey very, very simply, very, very hazard-free, and definitely in qualitative fashion and manner. Let me give one real-life example. Right today, if any class 4-5 students, if we ask, can you please add 83 plus 67, how much it is? Before going to answer of the question, that students will ask you, Papa, Mama, Ma'am, Sir, don't you have mobile? Don't you have calculator? Please give me, I will show you what will be the summation. Means they are using the summation tools of that research calculator, that mobile calculator, and also a separate calculator. So that is why these research tools will act as the kind of calculator or catalyst, why I can say, to accelerate the research work with very, very simply and very, very easily and tactfully, efficiently, because researchers will need to pay much more attention on the arena of particular content and domain of the knowledge, not the organization of the thesis. Not, we cannot expect that every subject scholar will be able to write a good English, like a English subject paper. But for the right of the research, there are many tools through which researchers can individually learn what about this kind of writing they need to develop by their own. Then you see, research tools and research methodology. Let me just distinction the specific mechanism or strategies used to collect, manipulate, or interpret data. And methodology is the general approach to the researchers taken in carrying out the research project. This approach dictates the particular tools the researcher selects. What actually I want to mean, that research methodology may have a questionnaire method, observation method, schedule method, interview method, and many more. as tools. The job of the methodology is how to select for a particular scholar, for a particular time, for a particular topic. That is the subject of the research methodology, for what particular requirements, what particular tools I need to select. So methodology is a kind of selection of alternative strategies, and research tools is a particular tools or facets or components or elements through which I can steer up my research work. Now, principles for construction of research tools, how to construct a research tools, how to choose a research tools better list. So these are the five. Due to time constraint, I'm not going to read it all. And the PDF version of this presentation, my host will cater all the presentation files to you, all those who have attended through their all mails. Okay, so I cannot read up all these things. Otherwise, I cannot take up you on the main C of the topic. Then let me come the first core agenda of today's, that is Rackster. See, before coming into Rackster, let me say something. Why Rackster? Why Rackster? There are many tools. There are many tools. But believe me, because of this pandemic, I am just lucky enough to introduce myself on this Rackster. And before that, the same work I have done with my own and by using 4 or 5 tools. But this Rackster magic is that if we able to use this Rackster, then I may not use 5 separate tools. So this is an umbrella of different tools of Rackster. Then the shortcomings of Rackster is that this is not the free or open access or open source tools. This is purely a corporate software. This is purely a corporate tools. Due to this pandemic, they are giving us free to access to accelerate the research work on our request. So by going their website, they have their mail ID through which if any institute librarian requests them, I think rest of the pandemic period, rest of the lockdown period, they may be, I'm not sure, on your request, they may give you permission for allow to use this Rackster on the user ID password base. Now, what is Rackster? What is its vision, mission? Rax is all set to boost up every researchers across the world and help them to become more effective, creative, and agile. Then what is the mission? Rax's mission is to become the personalized intellectual partner for every researcher, helping him or her intelligently during most of challenging situation of research journey. Now, what makes Rax unique to tools for research productivity? It connects the key research activities, that is literature study, structured note taking, brainstorming, drafting, and exploring, and many more. Here they have just given 5 facets on in one platform, thereby helping you to always stay focused. It connects scientific resources, scholarly papers, articles, blogs, videos, lectures, online courses with one's activities to provide adaptive, personalized suggestion. It connects the deluge of information consumed daily to ease memory recall issues. This helps you to quickly compare and contrast key aspects of what you read, analyze, and done. Let me give one real life example from a scholar's experience. Let's say that for completing the literature review chapter or to background study, one student or one scholars need to collect so much of research papers, maybe chapter of books, maybe 2-3 pages of a particular book, maybe journal article, maybe online, offline, newspaper, audio, video, interview, many things. Then it's very cumbersome to us to make it a file then market a marker pen fire from which particular area I do declare, I do type in my literature review chapter, introduction chapter, other chapters too. So it was so cumbersome work. And for that particular reasons, sometimes, I can say many a times, scholars is being misguided and deviated from his particular focus of objective and derailed with the methodology in the data analysis part, in the findings part, in the discussion part. And accordingly, there is no relation in between introduction, objective, and conclusion finding. Because it's very tedious job to start up, to compiling, to handle all such kinds of papers and make them chapterize, prepare the conspectus of the thesis, and complete the mirror of the thesis. So in that particular case, this register will help you. You can create chapter-wise project of a particular thesis, for a particular thesis of your research work. Let's say chapter one introduction, chapter two literature review, like that. Then for a particular project, for a particular chapter, you can upload your papers, maybe scanned, maybe image format, maybe PDF format, maybe downloaded format, HTML, whatever it is. Then soon after going to write up anything, you can open and have a hyperlink there that which particular text is being taken from what particular text. Okay. And which will also help you to prepare the in-text citation and referencing. So that's the beauty which actually available insights of the RACS. Then how is RACS artificial intelligence powered? It starts with understanding the meaning and context of what one read, highlight, annotate, draft, discuss, and explore. Then it observes how one's attention and thereby research need shifts while doing all these research activities. Based on that, it suggests useful resources for your projects. Not only that, let's say I am going to write up one particular arena, maybe one research paper, maybe any chapter like that. So I'm not able to find out what will be my possible sources of resources. So if I go through the RACS project, then that RACS project will help me to search many such kind of papers from different possible sources on my particular paper or chapter or projects. So that is the beauty of this RACS. It also starts connecting related ideas, arguments, claims, data, and experimental design among literature collection. Now, one question may pertinent after completion of my deliberation, you can ask me that, Dr. Saha, can you enlighten what about data privacy and security? Because once I upload my paper under a project of RACS, there is a chance of someone may copy paste, or before publishing my paper, someone may use it like that. So which is very, very issues relating to DRM, copyright, patent of unpublished paper. So let us see how RACS is going to save our privacy and security things. RACS comply with global regulation, including GDPR, about the use, see our privacy page. How, if we go the RACS privacy page agenda, there we will found how RACS is caring about our privacy and security of a particular scholar. If any work has significant intellectual property, RACS highly recommend to use the license setting features in RACS. It enables the concerned candidates to apply an appropriate Creative Commons copyright license on drafts and critics. So you see, the RACS is a kind of platform who are just going to accommodate all the different things under their platform so that one research scholars will run safely and properly. Under this Creative Commons copyright license features is also there. Then RACS team unambiguously declares that they will not use or provide any of your work or its derivative, published or unpublished, to any other third-party entity. RACS themselves come from academia and carry with their values the culture of the community and the importance of privacy rights. So it's very emphatically they have noted, there may have, after reading these slides, there may not have any doubt and queries and questions how DACS is going to maintain the data privacy and security issues. Now, how is collaboration on DACS different from other tools such as Google Drive and ELNS? Key focus is to facilitate researchers to work coherently on a project without worrying about privacy and the risk of losing their contribution. Collaboration on DACS ensures that access to the individual's own is not altered even if they leave or are revoked from projects. With DACS professional plan, the entire intellectual property can be monitored and controlled by supervisor or the team lead on behalf of the organization for much better project continuation and knowledge transfer. Then, what type of data public resources are indexed by DACS? 170 plus million research paper extracts from top class journals and proceedings, millions of open access full text papers, millions of articles of 9,000 plus top quality research magazines and blogs, daily releases from 1,000 plus research data and related news sources, 11,000 plus of recordings of tier one conference workshops, and thousands of online lectures, the entire Wikipedia. The second last point, let me exemplify that 11,000 plus recordings of tier one conference workshops and thousands of online lectures, video. Why this is so? You know, right today, Government of India, through its MHRD, through its body EGC, their basic proverb is inclusive education, inclusiveness of the education. So this DACS is also very kind enough, conscious enough, attending enough to address the physically disabled students, scholars, teachers, rather academics, for their needs to extend their big hands of cooperation for inclusive research. They have this kind of agenda that audio video is also under their platform. Now let me come. What does DACS browser plugin do? It helps to import any research resources from outside DACS, including Google Scholar, ResearchGate, academia.edu, publishers portal, etc., into one's research projects in DACS. You can add web links into projects or attach them to specific papers you are reading through its install the plugin link. Now, this is the homepage of DACS, where before coming this page, we need to go this login. And if we go this login, then it will ask me to log in with my institutional mail ID and password may be, of course, different. And before that, as I told you very beginning that before having this login, as it is a kind of, you know, corporate platform, the institute need to have subscribed or procured, or institute librarian may send a request to them for trial access, for free access during this COVID-19 era. So if they give you, then this login will act accordingly. Then this appreciated by researchers from more than 300 universities, right from one world-class universities, Toronto, Boston University, RMIT, MKUC, and there are many more. Here I'm just take screenshots, so only 5-6 it has been located here. Now, what are the important points soon after login or registering in the register that may be subdivided into 13 core agenda, right from create a project on DACS to benefits of institutional plan. Now let me give you just 1-2 slides of each agenda of register. See, this is a kind of user guide. You all will have this user guide. Before starting, you can download this research, this user guide 36 slides are there. Basically, I have taken up slides from their website. This is part of that. So user guide, you can take at first. Then sign up and get started. This is the sign up page. First name, last name, email, then password, and then you just click it next. They will send a confirmation mail to your mail ID, and there you need to verify the mail ID clicking here, and then you will be able to come up here that verify your email using confirmation code sent to your registered email ID. Soon after I am just registering or sign up, then this signal will come to my desktop, and I have to open my mail ID to verify that link. And once I click there, I will be directly asked to login page through that ID and password. And this is the after login password, and this is number one agenda, create a project on Lax. So add a project, the name of the title of the project, and then description of the project. You can give chapter one or the short title of your paper, then description about the paper or about your thesis. You can write 2-3 lines here and to identify your project from one to other distinction. Then this is, you see, document similarity framework. Here you can add literature, and also you can start write. What is the literature? Is a directory of all the reading material from journal article, conference papers, survey paper that you upload or import into this project. Then drafts. Drafts is a directory of all the documents, observation, ideas, research questions, or rough draft of your paper that you create or import as a study or experiment during the research life cycle. If we maintain this Lax platform, I think many wastage of printout or handout will be diminished surely, because this is fully machine version platform. And for these particular things, we are taking many times printout even before proofreading. We need to take printout of my draft chapter 1, 2, 3, 4 times to make it a final save. Then you see document similarity, every project literature into my box, file upload. I can do a file upload in 2-3 ways. How can I? So file upload from my computer, that is, or from my desktop, or from my this kind of pen drive, and from my Google Drive, and also from any direct URL, and then add literature into your project, research from your extraction. These are the ways through which I can add literature one after one. Then after uploading a paper, navigation bar will come here, a navigation bar to move between projects. So this is the project, this is the paper, whatever I have uploaded, and this is the access my profile. I can pick up, so details, attachment, and results panel. Then this is the PDF reader. Then this is the drawer to access current projects, literature, and drafts. So here it will show you how much literature you have uploaded here, and then navigation bar to move between projects. Then basic of Lax web app interface. What are the basic interface of apps? That is, quickly get around in Lax, navigate throughout the Lax web app. You see, we are having discover, projects, shared with me, profile, why Lax, about. These are the different items through which they are there. And this is the Souris Dasgupta, that is their experts of the team manager. And this is his mail ID. From their website, you can have it. Then swiftly navigate through projects. How can I navigate my projects? Drafts and literature, there are two icons. Switch to a different projects from one project by clicking this project drop-down menu. I can go another project, whatever I have created inside the project menu. Then research paper information, go to a project's homepage. There I can have the information of my research papers. Then identifying sections in a scientific manner. These are the way of the page and window. Then read, highlight, and annotate your literature. Read in expanded view. So whatever you have read out of a particular paper, you can mark here. Whatever you found that this part is required to my chapter, you can mark here, and Lax will automatically mark with its this kind of marker. So this will be done by the software itself Once you click there, that will be marked up. Then highlight and annotate literature. In this way, this will highlight and it will show you this will the part of whichever highlighted or required for your particular thing. And this will be parallelly going through like hyperlink, hyperlink, hyperlink like that. Then review the details of the article. How can I make a review of a particular article? Title of the article, authors, then tags, abstract of the paper, cited by this paper, license your review, all the related points, they will remind you so that you cannot do any mischiefs, so that you cannot do any wrong things, so that you cannot do any incomplete things. Lex will give you a kind of correct presenter, qualitative writer, qualitative scholar like that. Now cited by this paper, if you click here, you will have this screen. Then number six is review of literature. How can I make a review of literature? This is the paper and what are the main arguments of this paper? If I click here, everything will come here, a part of that. Yes, it's true. One question you may ask me that Nimaida, if everything is machine do, then what is the utility of the research? I can give you one very simple example. Well, there are many Bengali to English, Tamil to English, English to Tamil, Malayalam to, I mean, intra-language transfer translation software, there are many. But if sometimes if you transfer from Bengali to English, that translation may not be appropriate for your subject, for your content spirit, for your text spirit. And that is why you need to read what is your objective, what is your spirit of the text. If it is applicable, then only you can write up. They actually give you a sample, what may be a kind of token guide for you. Now it's your duty to approve it. It's your guide duty, whether it will be approved or may be rejected, like that. And let me give some example that, as I found from my daily life, particularly for my state, every state it's there are renowned thesis binder or book binder agency. And in my case, my state, particularly for South Bengal, there is a Calcutta, a good book binder, famous book binder called Dhor Binder. Many people, after having its CD, they went to Dhor Binder, not for binding of the thesis, but for grammar checking, but for good English writing, and then for binding. And they have the package. Would you like to check grammar through us? We have good English teacher in our agency. Okay, I will. Then you have to pay 5,000. Do you need to check grammar? Then you need to pay this much of money. Do you need to rewriting your thesis with good English? Then you need to pay this much of money before binding. So under a binder signboard, we are going to surrender my thesis, my intellectual creativity to a binder for judging me. So my learned colleagues, this is my humble request to all of you. Don't try to hand over your thesis and take it blindly that as that particular professor write up, as he write up. So this language, this text is very fine. That may not be important. That may not be feasible for your particular subject. And for this arena, let me quote one website, quote one university's name called Purdue University. They have their own OWL, online writing laboratory homepage. There you will have subject-specific writing guideline. I mean, the write-up of a research of social work and the write-up of a thesis of chemistry may not be the same. The write-up of a English or Bengali or Tamil literature or Odia literature may not be the same of economics and geography. So if I going to blindly depend any English translator, maybe software, maybe human being, that may misguide my research objective many a times. And I have experienced a lot many a times for that particular research deviation from its objective. So this is my humble indication. Those who are yet to be starting their research work and those who are guiding to many scholars, for them, I am not teaching them, just I am giving one signal. Don't depend blindly any software for translation And also don't blindly depend on a particular human translator. After translating, you just read out by your intellectual capacity, by your subject knowledge, then you just justify whether it is appropriate for me or not, then only you will take it. And this is actually what current research methodology is concerned. This may not be available in any research methodology books. This may not be noted out any particular journal article like that. This is actually a kind of our day-to-day life learning history. And from there, I am just uttering this kind of sentence. You may agree with me, you may not agree with me, because all we are living with our own perception. So I cannot encroach anyone's perception or understanding what he or she nurtured by his or her own conception. So I cannot intervene over there, but this is my humble submission. Now, get the right resources to push your research forward. How can I collect my target resources instead of going through search of blindly Google or any internet basket? That is a kind of mess of information. So to collect this kind of right resources to push my research forward, I can search by these things. This is actually called easily discovered relevant materials to read. Then fine tune the recommendation. Whatever recommendation given by the RACS platform, I have to fine tune what I have told on the last slide. Now get quick conceptual clarity of the concepts in the paper. So it's my duty to find out the clarity of my own creation. No one will take the responsibility, neither RACS, nor any other people, nor my guide, take the responsibility whether I have maintained the clarity or not. And because of maintaining of the clarity, quantum of clarity, depending on the quality of the research work. So find supplementary resources using selective rigging, R-Y-G-G-I-N-G, rigging. So these options is also there under the RACS. Then attach and organize useful content and references easily. From here, my colleagues, Sujit, due to his illness, the day before yesterday, we have the agenda of EndNote, the reference management tools. The same has been presented by Dr. Subhashree Nag from the platform itself, that is Clarified Analytics. So that software also be correlated by this RACS, so that your usefulness or preparation of these references and bibliographies and in text citation will be very handy and kind of ready-made. And here I can say that EndNote is not the free and open access software. EndNote is again definitely a corporate software. If anyone is having Web of Science membership or accessibility through EsearchSynth in FlipNet, then only they will be get this web, this EndNote as free, otherwise not. So here I am just going to say, you can use EndNote, but it is very limited scope. So it's better to go by Zotero and or Mendeley. Then adding recommendation from RACS as attachment. How can I make attachment? Here also you see adding external attachment. How can I make attachment? Symbols are here. How can I make fine tune? That guidelines is also here. Sample is also available in their portal. Then attach reference, custom URL, file upload, and many things here they have uploaded. Am I audible clearly? Okay. Then attach and organize useful content and reference easily and quickly. And I am sure, just 1 month back, I am just going to acquaint myself with this RACS term. If any scholar during his starting, if university having accessibility of this RACS term, if anyone just pays 7 days, 10 days time, I am confident enough that their thesis submission will be 6 months before or earlier, as well as their thesis will be a qualitative fashion and manner, at least to some extent. Then point 10, work faster with collaborators. How can I find out the collaborators of my particular work or paper write-up? Collaborative learning through sharing of literature. How can I do so? That is also available there. Then you see, document your ideas, thoughts, and work in progress. How can I just measure my progress of work? That options is also available there. Then let me come, search, discover, and save content. How can I search? How can I discover? How can I save my content? So that is also there. Then this is the extended page of that number 12, that is feeding. How can I bookmark, search and filter content, resource categories, search query, then results. Then search, discover and save content go beyond simple keyword search. You can go some other advanced search level with the use of this WAX platform. Then faster content discovery in the early stage of research. So when we are just going to start, when we have little bit conception about my literature collection and other things, that particular time, we need to have faster content discovery in the early stage of research. This time, this have immensely come to your help for the collection of literature, for feeding the literature, to conceptualize the background of your research problem. It will be a kind of really helpful tools to all of you. The benefits of institutional plan. They have several institutional plan for their commercial practice. So any university, depending on their need, depending on their scope, ability of their fund, they can choose this institutional plan. So get personalized updates from library, that is also there. Then benefits of institutional plan under here, there are many plan by their from their sites. We can go and learn a lot about that. I am not going all that plans. I don't have much time to go all their facets and scope to go about that. And see how to contact with RACS. So one question, soon after my deliberation is over, you may ask me, Nimaida, how can we contact with? By their web page, they have their inbuilt send us a message options through which we can have directly contact with them, or under the contact, they have this info at rackstar.io, mail ID is there, through which, and their basic agenda is to extend cooperation and extend their big hands to be with us. So anyone may contact with them for their university, for their institute, to have the free access or trial access of this Rackstar for 1 month or sometimes during this COVID-19 to accelerate their research work and to extend support the academics for easy academic work. Then let me go Grammarly. Perhaps many of you have heard the name of the Grammarly. So by its name, it's very easy to make an idea what this Grammarly may contain. And here I can say emphatically that Grammarly means, let us take English literature grammar or English grammar or any language grammar, what I actually mean. See, this grammar means punctuation, spelling, then transformation, then good writing technique, technology. All these four, five agenda will come here. Therefore, what I'm going to say is that if Rackstar will be the right hand of the researchers, then Grammarly would have been the left hand of the scholars. If any institute have these tools, these two tools, then I think the scholars and the academics will run hazard-free to steer up their publication work, scholarly works, and I'm sure this will accelerate the quantity and quality of publication both, because many times we have to spend to collect the literature, many times we have to spend to write a good English for our particular subject, where we actually may have some lacuna. So to overcome that particular lacuna, this Rackstar and Grammarly may help you a lot. Until the time, if you don't have any scope to subscribe or procure these two, I just humbly recommend or request or humbly submission before you all that, please try to log in, which is full free, Purdue University OWL page, where you will have several agenda relating to research, right from plagiarism checking, citation style, English writing style, then also subject specific writing style, then how to write a CV, how to write a resume, what are the difference between resume and CV, and being an expert, you can part of that online writing laboratory so that you can also discharge your expertise for enhancement of the global level scholarly works. So you see, why this Grammarly? Why? So this is actually digitally writing assistance supports clear and effective communication. At Grammarly, we strive to help all people feel heard and understood whenever and wherever they communicate. More than 20 million people around the world use this artificial intelligence powered product every day to strengthen their writing and say that they really mean. Writing assistant supports clean, mistakes-free writing while offering suggestions that go way beyond grammar. Cutting-edge technology pushes forward what's possible, using a variety of innovative approaches, including advanced machine learning and deep learning. We consistently break new ground in natural language processing research to deliver unrivaled assistance in our product offering. That is why we are recognized by First Company as one of the world's most innovative AI companies. And read more about Grammarly. These all are available in their portal, so I may not go about that. Then value informs everything from who we are to what we build. So value informed everything means from who we are to what we build. At Grammarly, it all starts with being eager, ethical, adaptable, gritty, empathetic, and remarkable. So we all are eager. So here they nicely exemplify every letters of the word eager by the basic metaphor of research methodology, basic metaphor of more specifically English writing called ethical writing, adaptability, gritty, empathicity, and remarkability. So they are deliberate about applying these values to everything they do, whether it is committing to an inclusive and learning-oriented work environment, supporting their users with compassion and integrity, or thoughtfully creating products that connect people. And there are many plans, Grammarly availability on different plans. Plans, Grammarly Premium, Grammarly Business, Grammarly.edu, Grammarly Desktop X, Grammarly Keyboard, Grammarly for MS Office. There are many alternatives for accessibility, for procurement. So based on the requirement, based on the availability of fund, any institute may contact with them to procure any one of the agenda. Now this is the homepage of the Grammarly. So basically sometimes it is free, the current plan and premium plan and business plan. And free plan, what are the options are there? That is there. Since it's a screenshot, that bottom part is not visible. Through its website, you can go with that. Free part is very, very limited features. So free action we cannot take up. Only this grammar, spelling, and punctuation. This consistency in spelling and punctuation, that is not available in free version. Then fluency is not. So many things are not available in free version. Then Grammarly, how to register? There are three-step easy guideline they have given to us before registering the site. You see, step one, go to www.grammarly.com/edu. Mandatory to sign up for this URL. Then stop. Then step two, click on Join Your Organization button. There is a soon after getting the grammarly.com/edu, we will have one button in the right hand corner called Your Organization. Once we click there, if they activate free access to us, then only that button will actively open and I will be given one window. Fill up the self-service form, very nascent information, full name, then mail ID, then position, like that, department, etc. Then ensure that users are registering from their respective official email ID. Yes. For us, we need to register on the mail ID of our official, that is extension is @bishwarthi.ac.in. Any personal mail that cannot be logged in. So step three, after clicking sign up, an activation email will be sent to the user institutional email ID, like Rackstar. So please note, your @edu credential verification has been activated, and an activation email will be sent to the user's institutional email ID once he or she registers or sign up. Users may at times get this in spam or junk folder due to mail setting. Users are advised to check up the spam folder in case the link is not received in inbox. Like our case, every day my host is sending the link of the registered participants before the night of the session to joining of the meeting link. But many times we receive a phone, a message that I am not receiving mail. So our humbly request to all of them, like that fashion, sometimes this mail, instead of landing in the inbox, it may many times land on some spam or junk box. So if you click here, that mail might be available there too. Then you see step four, kindly verify the activation mail from Grammarly. Once registered, users will land on the Grammarly editor, which is easily to use and can be explored by the users. The MS Word plugin can be downloaded from the support page after registration from the link, that is http://www.grammarly.com/admin/window. The same user ID and password credentials will be granted access to use this plugin or for users. So after activation of the registration, before taking entry in the Grammarly editor, it is suggested to get download of this Grammarly editor of MS Office through MS Office plugin, and by using the same ID password through that portal. Then how to use Grammarly? This is very important. What is this? You see, go to URL, click on login, enter email ID and password, and then you will land the Grammarly homepage. You can create a new blank document or upload an existing document to edit it with Grammarly. Document format for uploading should be Microsoft Word, Doc or DocX. OpenOffice means ODT, then TXT and RTF. Mind it, PDF file is not accessible or checkable by Grammarly, because you know PDF file is not, or image file is not inside readable as text. So therefore, mind it, this file format should be maintained and uploaded in the Grammarly and for the necessary checkup. Then select the language type in customized section by using these things. Then accounts, customized language preference, it will be checked accordingly on different Unicode compliant language. Grammarly is now activation. Then yes, now six, if you have already existing file, upload document, or else you start writing a new document by checking new, select the document type, click on goals to set audience type, formality domain tone, and intent of other papers you are writing, and click on done. Then is what is, then click on apply. Then click on plagiarism. You see, the beauty of the Grammarly is by their page you can have automatically 1-3 plagiarism checking facilities within their platform. This may not be acceptable in the light of the UGC InfliNet, as they are giving us Urkund as free software to check our papers, and which will be the basic parameter for judging your paper in the Indian Penal Code. So that is why still this will give you a kind of primary idea how my paper is going on. So this is the features. So then you will have this click on plagiarism. Plagiarism will be usually switched off. Kindly switch it on every time you log in, right button corner. There you can have it on. Rectify all alerts issue. Click on the overall score, right top corner. Here you will be given right examination marks. You will be given marks, how much marks you have been given for what particular write-up quality. Okay, then click on download the PDF report. The MS Word plugin can be downloaded from the support page after registration from the link, as I told. And this is the tutorial. It is available from their web portal. You can have this tutorial too. Now this is the Grammarly homepage sort thing. This is the browser, desktop, mobile, and Grammarly editor. These are the formats it is available. Now write your best with Grammarly for. This is the text. I cannot, due to time shortage, I'm not going to read all these things. This is available in the portal. Then Grammarly for Windows. This is the Grammarly for Windows page, which you can download. Then to improve lives by improving communication, that option is also there in the Grammarly. Then demo document, the basics. If you download, if you want to see, you see misspelling and grammatical errors on effect, or your credibility, the sum goes for misused commas, this is there. Then in the dictionary, it will be given what is the wrong word and what will be the alternatives or right word for your wrong things. So here actually, by red button, they are just giving you the wrong spelling and wrong used. And in the side button, all alternatives will be given here. We can click and we can add the dictionary from the right word in my draft. This is the demo document. Once I upload my particular paper, I will have it the actual mirror of my writing quality or suggestion from the Grammarly. Then this is the Grammarly dashboard. You can upload a new paper. Then this is a demo document, and you can just my Grammarly, my account, apps, premium. Then you can also log out for every using time after every use. Then this is the new document upload. This is the one can also upload another document for checking after you have started editing, or simply use these options. So type your title, you can check it, and this is the new document uploading. Then overall score, goals. After uploading a paper, you will be given a marks. Out of 100, how much marks you will be given for a particular write-up as far as Grammarly editor is concerned. Okay, so then consciousness, that is another option of this Grammarly. If a suggestion is incorrect or you would like to report it for many reasons, click the three dots, choose your preferred options to proceed. So every time you will get this kind of three dots and so on symbol, and where you will just have some sort of your option. Then this is the editor setting, where you can have just setting the editor. This is on and off button. You can choose on the basis of your requirement. So disable the auto jumping to the next alert, increase the font size of the document. And these are the several options inside there. Then this is the download and many more options. Downloading a document, how to download a document. I mean, after checking, how to, just like a plagiarism checking from Urkun, how to download a PDF version of my report so that you can download. Then the performance, word count also, how much if a paper contains a word. Many times from any seminar, from any journals, we are having that your papers will be 5,000 words, your papers will be 10,000 words, like that. So Grammarly will give you the word count, words, then sentence two. Also how much sentences is there, then reading time, how much second it will require to reading time by the Grammarly itself, then speaking time, how much time it will take to speak, then 1 minute, 20 seconds. So ample of features are there, and also readability inside the Grammarly, so that it is now a very, as good as ready-made cooked food, ready-made food only to serve and eat. So this, what I can say repeatedly, that Rackster is the left hand, then Grammarly is the right hand of Write Today's Academic Society first tearing up. So get expert writing help. If I want to take writing help from expert, I can take it up. And for plagiarism, this is the button you can click and take up. So plagiarism checking, you see 17%, my car team turn paper, and you can take our download from after checking what are the matches from what different sources your similarity has been identified by the Grammarly. That will also be given here, this URL, and from this URL you can directly click here. This will be give you the mirror view, whatever available in your paper and whatever available in the original resource or the URLs. So that will be replicated, and from where you will just readily understood from where I have taken this part, I need to now cite and refer to bypass the plagiarism. Now, expert writing service also is available there. I'm not going all these things. And then the writing experts can review your work for correctness only or for correctness and clarity. If you choose correctness only, they will correct any spelling, grammar, or punctuation issues. If you choose correctness and clarity, they will correct mistakes and make your work more concise, precise, and easy to read. You can then choose your preferred turnaround time and other editing options to help us provide you with personalized correction. So you see, they have two features, correctness and clarity. You may choose correctness only, then only they may give you the find out the wrong things. And if you choose the opt the clarity options, then they will identify the wrong things. Also, they will supply you possible right things with concise, precise, and skilled manner. Then 10 best Grammarly alternatives in 2020. If any university, any institutes may not have the options to procure the Grammarly, then how do they proceed? There are many open access platforms as good as Grammarly, but I'm very confident the free and open access may not be the equal compatible as good as Grammarly is. Still, my proverb here will be something is better than nothing. Something is better than nothing. If you don't have anything, so you can go around by this 10. So Pro Writing Aid, White Smoke, Ginger, Jetpack, Paperator, Slickwrite, iChecker, Online Correctness, Hemingway, Reverso. There are many. I am just giving showcase this only 10 important. And you see, as I told you very morning before to start, this question is remains questions because of this time also. I am just more than 1 hour, 10 minutes I am taking from your valuable time. So online demonstration, let me not to proceed because online demonstration will take much time. Our net also today is very slow. So let me wrap up my presentation by going to conclusion. See, conclusion is what I say, digital tools for researchers is now very, very useful and indispensable if it is practicable to made available for them. And what these research tools may done for us, that is explore the literature, find and share data and code, connect with others, experts, all the bench and in office, write my paper, publish my academic creation, evaluate my academic research before to publish. So these are the 7 core agenda or alternatives. What today's digital research tools are going to deliver for the scholarship publications. Now, it allows the researchers to get on with the research and not to be sidetracked into reinventing the wheel. It allows others to verify and or follow on with reported results due to standardization of measurements, improvements in measurements through testing research. Often, the measurement tools can only surpass current cutting edge by serious research of the tools making process. And I cannot wrap up my presentation without the quotation of one of my model personality in India in the academic pedagogy, not only pedagogy. I am very lucky to have him as one of the presidents of government of India, that is none other than Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, who supposed to be the shadow, the mirror of Indian research and education system. That is, all birds find shelter during a rain, but eagle avoids rain by flying above the clouds. So problems are common, but attitude makes the difference. Let me repeat again. All birds find shelter during a rain, and most of them coming to the nest. But eagle avoids rain by flying above the clouds. Therefore, eagle is also find out shelter to save from or refrain from the rain by going and jumping up of the clouds. In conclusion, problems are common, but attitude makes us the difference. And you see, we are living in the rainy season, and our rural India is under gloomy sky, muddled ways. There is no clear path to maintain our daily life. Yes, in addition to that, we have Amphan, we have COVID-19. And let me just equate that our research path is on the same way very gloomy, is same way on the very muddled, and under pandemic, every now and then, free from COVID-19. So be careful, be attentive enough to save your future life from any mischiefs, from any plagiarism case. And finally, let me say, as a presenter, thanks for joining, listening, and holding patience by this 1 hour 15 minutes to bother me. Thank you all. And let me just open up for 1-2 questions. And I request my host, if there is any pertinent questions from the chairman,
one question we received from Mohu Chakraborty, Sangeet Bhavan, PhD. Is Rax Works working with Bengali version file?
The answer is, if it is any kind of file, Bengali version is not the right version. We need to check whether it is any kind of file. If it is any kind of file, you have used the software, then a part of that, but not for software, because it is not.
Yes. Essentially, the function that in the regional language must actually be to basically software working on the visual and community of the
function that is that audience is muted on here. Please make your audio available. It is under the mark. So, if it is available on the backend page, then it will run and you can try to record
through Unicode online version of the
process. Okay.
All are requested. If you have, then you unmute your microphone, otherwise, not. So, another question from the another student that from Vishwabharati, is Grammarly services available for VV student, that is Vishwabharati student?
At present, it is not available. We have not even available, but it is available.
Sir, can I ask something?
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
I just wanted to check.
Ma'am, you are not audible.
Okay.
You can please you unmute your microphone. Yeah, you, right now you are audible. Yeah, you carry on, please.
What I'm trying to say is lecture possibly compare visuals as well, because we do with designs and also sometimes we have to compare visuals in our text.
Yeah, may I request you to repeat the question?
What I'm trying to say is Rexter can also help us say if I have a visual and a caption with it, can it help comparing visuals or something? Or is it only?
See, actually, as far as visual or mind is concerned, I think it is not available to supply as a but I think one thing is right there. That is, then I will be able to give the right answer of your question. We can anything?
Yeah, I couldn't hear very well. Maybe I'll ask you later on the
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you so much. Any question from anybody? We are taking the question. If you have any question, then you can ask me or you can write in the chat box also.
One small question, sir.
Yes.
Yeah, can Dr. Saab send this, the video, one example for video of how to use this Rackstar practically, on the basis of a small literature, an example for that one. Can you, sir?
Because of time, I'm not going directly. This is the let me just share the screen first. Started, then why Rex content user guide discovered. You can see from here that after uploading or creating any project, the research by the title paper, research papers, blogs, courses, news, these are the several things. Once you upload here, your paper will be like here. Now you can share. Then you can take a text from here. You can import, export, and you can just going into your project box, you can take a copy paste of your project like that. Okay, so it's available there. And how can just compare view will come. That video is also available in their web portal, which is free, because for seeing that things you may not require to procure. By taking login of their web, you just go through that. If you have any specific questions, my mail ID will be in the things and my PPT will be sent you all. So you can raise any specific questions afterwards. Definitely I will take care. If I'm not able to give you answers, I will try to ask Rex people to give you queries of the particulars. Okay.
Rex is free, sir? This software is free?
No. It is not free. Due to this COVID-19 period pandemic, they are kind enough to offer us free access during the period 30th July till 30th July. They have given us free. From your institute, you can send one request to them. If they think, then they may give you 1 month free access like that. And that will be very useful. Okay. I think you
Thank
can.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. May I know where from are you?
I am from ICFA University. I am a PhD scholar from
ICFA University. From ICFA University, you can ask your librarian or your director to have a contact with them, these Rex people. Then they may have a contact with them. And I think for 1 month, considering this COVID-19 period, they are very kind enough. Most of the institutes, those who are request them, they are kind enough to provide access. Okay, for 1 month at least. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Thank you for your nice question and taking part of this.
Thank you.
So I think.
Nimaida, I have a question. Hello.
Yeah,
Yeah, Nimaida, Rukapa Mukherjee, Zoology Department. Maybe I missed the point. Is Grammarly free for us?
Yeah, no, really you have missed the point. Right from Grammarly, actually available Vishwa Bharati, this same answer, this COVID-19, they have given us free till
okay for this period only.
Apna jodi WhatsApp number ta amake janan ekhoni thik ache amader faculty dara group ache amra faculty group apnake jog kore debo okhane amra somosto amader news gulo post kori apni okhane details ta peye jaben thik ache
acha
apni amar number e amake
ekটু কথা মেসেজ আমি জানিয়ে দেব
ওকে ঠিক আছে
থ্যাংক ইউ আই উইল ডু ইট থ্যাংক ইউ নিমাইদা
ওকে ওকে এন্ড আই থিংক questions is a kind of, you know, unending process. So we can wrap up the session, and the question answering session will be taken a kind of next course of actions, because we are open every time for this kind of questions and answer. And now let me jump up to symbolic, this kind of concluding remarks. So from the participants, for our encouragement, I am confident that many lacks during this 10-day presentation we have faced and we have traveled. Still, you see, we all are beggars of appreciation and also lovers of taking positive feedback from your side, so that we will rectify ourselves and get some sort of inspiration to take up the challenge of steering or conducting third webinar. So that I'm just requesting some people from Vishwa Bharati, some academics from Vishwa Bharati, and some from other institute to please very short, and before to give, please introduce yourself, your name and institute, because it's a kind of recording is going on. We want to record your voice, your valuable opinion, and also from other than Vishwa Bharati also, just 1 and 2 minutes, sir. Please, just one by one, my host will, you just give signal through message box, chat box, my host will give you the signal, then he will. Otherwise, if everyone at a time unmute yourselves, then it will be a kind of mess. No one will be audible and our recording will be a kind of mess. So may I request just 5 minutes, we will go to take up the opinion from the participants, how your feelings and what is your suggestions on our future course of journey. May I request our Professor Amitabh Bandyopadhyay, Department of Physics, to say something, because sir, you have attended almost all the sessions. We are very keen to listen something from your side. Please, if you highlight, we will be grateful to you. Professor Amitabh Bandyopadhyay, please.
Yes, yes. Hello. Am I audible?
Yeah, yeah, please.
Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Yeah, thank you. I have attended all the presentations, starting from the very first one. Our Vice Chancellor, Professor Vin Chakraborty, and his advisors. Now, what I have found is that many closed doors are now open. That is the main thing. So many options are there, and we can avail so many different types of support from different portals. That is the main advantage which I have gathered, main thing about this webinar. Actually, I thought it would be a first sort of exposure for me to attend something like a webinar. But after finishing this one, after attending this one, it is clear that this should be the norm of the future. And in fact, while at the end I was thinking of, in our department, we are thinking of arranging something similar with the help of our library. So maybe regularly, in some regular fashion, we may arrange for something similar. Actually, this is very informative and accessible. That is the main thing. We can access, we can join from our office, from our home, at any time. It's very convenient. And I really appreciate our library, librarian and his support staff. Is really, really very, very helpful for us. It's very, very nice.
Thank you, sir, for your nice words. Okay, okay. Then may I request Professor Apurva Chattopadhyay to say something? Apurva, please. Professor Apurva Chattopadhyay, Department of Economics and Politics. I think he is not in the line. Dr. Sukumar Pal, may I request to say something, Dr. Sukumar Pal?
Yes, can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm hearing.
Yeah. Okay. So actually I'm from session number 6 onwards, because the registration process was such that I could not pick out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 6 onwards I am just attending, and all the sessions were really useful, especially for the researcher and faculty member. Many of the researchers are also just asking me that if we get other avenues, in the sense particularly based on the subject, definitely they could also use. But in general, they have got many things, particularly using the software, like SPSS, and other software also being given information, and live demo was it was really very useful. Now particularly, instead of, I would suggest taking up only one software or the package, which will be helpful if it is given for 2-3 days. The intensive kind of the hand, if it is given, so many of the researchers and also benefited. So next time, if such kind of training is provided, it will be lovely for the faculty and researcher. Thank you, Nimaida, for just knocking me.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Then, may I have Dr. Atul Kumar Raj? I think he's.
Dr. Anup Kumar Roth from Howrah.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, please say something on this session.
The whole session is really beautiful, and I think the Tagore's idea is highly maintained here. All the presenters are from Vishwavati University, and we're proud of that. And thank you, all session are unique. It was full of comments and explanations are good. So we are very much reached by the whole program. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Any?
Thank you, sir.
Then
Agonu Rahul Kumar. Amut Kumar.
Amut.
AMOD.
Amut Kumar. Dr. Amut Kumar from Bhagalpur. Hello. Rajkot. Mr. Atunu Pal from Rajkot. Hello. If you want to say anything on this lecture series, please say. Hello. After this session, we would like to send our feedback form. So then you will fill up the form.
Dr. Nandalal Mandal.
Nandalal Mandal.
May I request Dr. Nandalal Mandal to say something from Vishwabharati University, Dr. Nandalal Mandal. Is he in the line?
Nandanal Mandal,
May I request Nandanal Mandal to say something?
Just Can I audible?
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. All the session is very well and very informative. And I request for again some other topics you may organize such type of webinar. Thank you, sir, for organizing.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Subroto, may I request Dr. Subroto Vishwas, please say something. Hello. Okay.
Hello. Can I speak?
Yeah. Hello.
Am I audible?
Yeah, audible. Please.
First of all, thank you for all of you to organize such a.
Vikas Kumar.
Vikas Kumar.
Thank you.
I'm also a part of this university. I study in MPhil during my period. Nimaida, can I speak some Hindi?
No problem.
सबसे पहले मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर जैसा कि मतलब उन्होंने कहा भी है, शिक्षा को लेकर काफी उन्होंने काम भी किया, तो उसी तरह से मतलब निमायदा अपने मतलब विश्वविद्यालय मतलब जो विश्व भारती है उसमें जो पुस्तकालय है उसको लेकर सर ने बहुत सारा काम किया है। मैं शुरू से देखता भी आ रहा हूँ, उनके साथ भी काम किया हूँ कई बार विजुअली हैंडीकैप बच्चों को लेकर। और सर ने मतलब 10 दिन का जो कार्यक्रम रखा है वो काफ़ी बेहतर रहा। जितने वक्ता आए हैं सब ने अपने मतलब अलग अलग वक्तव्य से हम लोग प्रभावित किया, काफ़ी कुछ सीखने को मिला। सबसे पहले तो जो रिसर्च स्कॉलर है उनको मतलब टेक्निकली चीज़ों को सीखने को मिला कि बहुत सारे जो सॉफ्टवेयर हैं जिस चीज़ से लोग अनभिज्ञ हैं, नहीं जान पाते हैं सॉफ्टवेयर के बारे में, किस तरह से यूज करना है, किस तरह से एक्सेस करना है, सारे चीज़ों को लेकर मतलब एक अच्छा सा मतलब व्याख्यान दिया गया इस 10 दिन के सेशन में। मैं हर दिन मतलब डिसिप्लिन के साथ बैठता हूँ और सुन रहा था हर दिन। और आज का सेशन सर का तो बहुत अच्छा ही रहा क्योंकि हर चीज़ सर ने पूरा कंक्लूजन के साथ ही अपनी बात को रखा। तो मैं आखिर यही कहना चाहता हूँ कि जितने भी हैं आप लोग मतलब जिस तरह से एक संगठित होकर इस तरह सेमिनार करा रहे हैं, आगे मैं चाहता हूँ कि इस तरह सेमिनार विश्व भारती में होता रहे और मैं इस सेमिनार का पार्ट बनता रहूँ।
ओके, थैंक यू। प्रियंका मंडल, संस्कृत डिपार्टमेंट विश्व भारती। हेलो प्रियंका मंडल।
Want to say that I attend all the sessions of this webinar organized by PBL, and it is our opportunity. We are thankful to the authority because in this such a lockdown period we cannot go to library direct, but through this webinar we know that how we can access from our home the online resources and so many artifacts we know about webinar, and the resource persons clarify our questions and we know many new things from our can happen in future also. So thank you, Vishwa Bharati library team to organize such a program.
Thank you. May I request Jilam Hajra from Umesh Chandra College?
Hello.
हेलो चिलम हाजरा आप उमत चंद्र कॉलेज अच्छा लाइन आछे ओके ओके
So, actually, education society, all members, see, actually, education as well as research is a journey, not a decision. So, I cannot say, and I am not intending to say, let us say, farewell like that. But these sessions are open and tomorrow. Let us say this discussion, this seminar, this webinar, these sessions all are just opening up window of research or academic journey. Therefore, during last 10 sessions, you have hold your patience and kind enough to bother us in every odds and events. And by your words, yes, it's true, in any public domain, you cannot utter any loopholes or lacuna of my mission of this webinar, second webinar. That regards, you are kind enough that you have encouraged us, and including me, all of my teammates have been found inspiration and motivation to take up another session, may not be this 10 days lingering, but special sessions at least once in a week we will conduct. Okay, then we will just gear up our research and academic journey with safe and proper fashion and manner. And by legacy of Gurudev Tagore, those who are outsiders of Vishwabharati, or those who are not the part and parcel of Vishwabharati Parivar, I want to just message them, don't think that we are not the part of Vishwabharati. You all are part of Vishwabharati because we all are Indian, and we all are fighting for the development of India. So in any academic parameter, if you need any research assistance, if you send an email for plagiarism checking for any article, we will try to take care to the extent possible from our side to uphold the legacy of Vishwabharati and also the legacy of Gurudev Tagore, to extend our big umbrella for the academic society. And you know, technology and by other means, we may have So we may have some lacks sometimes, or many a times we may not able to address the needs of the academic fraternity because we are having so much of shortcomings as far as infrastructure is concerned, 24/7 network, and also some bandwidth and other problems. Every day we are suffering from network connection and other things. That's why, and also fund and other problems, we are not able to procure our resources as required by the academics. So this is our lacks, but we only have the mentality, the attitude to explore our efficiency, to explore our attitude of cooperation before you all, with which we will proceed with hand to hand in our next course of academic journey. And most likely, Dr. Sutaba Mukherjee from Department of Geology, Vishwabharati, intend to say something. So just let me stop 1-2 minutes, take up the ma'am's opinion, then only I will take care and conclude the seminar by saying, and after ma'am's, I will say 1-2 minutes more, then I will request you all to unmute your video, so that my host will take the group pictures, which we are actually looking for. So, and we have some small announcement regarding certification, regarding feedback link and other things. So 2-3 minutes I will speak. So let me just request Professor Sutapa Mukherjee. Sutapa Mukherjee from Department of Geology, Vishwabharati. Ma'am, please, now floor is yours.
Hello.
Yes, Nimaida, am I audible?
Yeah, you are clearly audible.
Yeah. It has been a wonderful experience for me.
No, you are not audible. Somehow you have disconnected. Please. We are not audible your sentence.
Okay, is it okay now?
Yeah, please repeat
it's
again.
It's getting muted. Yeah. So I just wanted to share that I had a wonderful experience.
Again, it is dropped.
It is getting muted on its own. Uh-huh. Okay, fine. Is it audible now? It's getting muted on its own.
Yeah. It is now audible. Please continue. Not audible.
Some problem is there.
I think so. Sutapadi, may I request you to write your opinion in the chat box? Please write your opinion in the chat box. I'm just going to take it. Okay. So let me know. Please. By July 7 or 8, they will send the certificates to you all through mail, which will be generated by online software. So here everything we are doing online software and free of cost. So feedback form will be sent by today. You are expected to return the feedback form by two days. Then by first week of July, my host will take care about the generation of certificate, and 7-8 like that, or as early as possible, they will send you back the certificate through you all. There is any mistakes, please do contact with my co-host and host. They will take care about the things. And at the very last stage, I would just like to express and extend my deep sense of gratitude to the Honorable Upacharya Vishwabharati, Professor Vidyu Chakraborty, for allowing us to conduct the session and also taking part for delivering one valuable speech in the starting day. So thank you, our Honorable Upacharya sir, and also Registrar ma'am and other university administration like Joint Registrar, Academic Research, Joint Registrar Accounts, Joint Deputy Registrar Administration, Deputy Registrar Estate, Joint Registrar Examination, Joint Registrar Estate, and also Joint Finance Officer, and also Finance Officer, and also all other teachers, directors, principals, faculty members, research scholars, then my esteemed students, and also the staff in general, and the staff in particular of Vishwabharati Library Network, and more specifically to host Dr. Tapas Kumar Das, Deputy Librarian Vishwabharati, and Dr. Sonod Bhattacharya, who happens to be the Assistant Librarian of Vishwabharati. They jointly soldiering this bigger event during last 10-15 days, they are carrying these things. So I am really, on behalf of the Vishwabharati Library Authority and Vishwabharati Authority too, to extend our big hands to them. And I do solicit for same cooperation from them for new course, next course of journey. And last but not least, I am really thankful those who have joined every day by passing the technological threads in and out of Vishwabharati, in and out of West Bengal, right from Kashmir, Rajasthan, Guwahati, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur, and many states, MP, Maharashtra, UP, Bihar, Jharkhand, Orissa, and almost all the states, even from Andaman, almost all the Tripura also, we have received representation from almost all the states, then also South, Tamil, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Kerala also. So your help, your joining, your opinion, your comments through chat help us to steer up these things. So with these few words, let me wrap up the session, and with a request for 2 minutes, please unmute your video so that my host will take group photos. And without unmuting your audio, please just mute your video. Mute your video. This is my fervent appeal to all. All participants, esteemed participants, gathering, requested to unmute your video.
Very, very useful and informative lecture. Thank you so much. Now, may I request all of you to open your video to take a session photo. Please open your video. We will take a session photo. So one more, just 1 minute, 1 second. Not open. Okay, thank you so much. Let me end the session. Okay, thank you.
রেকর্ডিং হয়েছে তো? টুইট করলাম, করবো না আমার এখন দেখ, ইউ আর নাও হোস্ট অফ দিস মিটিং। ও তাহলে আপনাকে আবার জয়েন করতে হবে।
हाजिर ऊपर नहीं हो
Meeting recording is in process. Thank you.